So today's video is basically a sitting down video because we haven't done this since a really, really long time. I guess it was 6-7 months back that I discussed and showed what all were my favorites. So I thought, why not just sit today and chit-chat with you guys and just show you what are the things I have been loving and using over time. And I couldn't share with you these things. Some of the stuff you might have already seen in some of my haul videos or lookbooks, but some things are new, so I really, really wanted to share this with you all. And yeah, without any further ado, let's just get started. So the very first thing which I'm really, really loving and I've been crushing is this lipstick, which is from Avon. This is the shade which I'm currently wearing. It is from their Simply Pretty Ray, and this is basically such a bubbly pink color. I mean, I love my reds and my wines and my nude colors, but this is something which really, really attracted me. Look at this, guys. It's so beautiful. So this lipstick is really, really beautiful, guys, and I really, really love the texture. It's so smooth on the lips. You don't have to apply any lip balm or anything. It doesn't dry your lips. And for me, for someone like me who eats lipstick, because you know I have the habit that if I'm eating, then my lipstick would also, which is really bad, but you know, it happens with me. But this one is really, really long lasting and it stays for me also. So I guess it's a big, big thumbs up for this lipstick. And I really, really love the new range which Avon has come up. So this is of course my very first favorite thing. So the next thing is jewelry. So we are going to talk about jewelry. I have two earring pairs which are really, really beautiful, which I got from Mira Road Market. So I was there, and you know that market is really, really awesome in jewelry. So I couldn't resist and I got these two pair of earrings. So let's talk about this one first. You might have already seen me wearing in my Instagram stories. I wore it on one of my friend's wedding and with the sari. So this is really, really beautiful and this is how it looks. So these are a little heavy, but these are really beautiful and they came for just 100 rupees. I really, really love them and I'm currently crushing on them. They're really, really beautiful. And the second pair of earrings are these beautiful jhumkas. I really, really love these jhumkas. They're really beautiful and these one are in white and gold. So I did not have, I had a full gold one, but this one, I really love the texture. It's really beautiful. I really, really love this. This one came for just 80 rupees. So I really love both of these earrings and I guess I'm gonna wear them a lot. So yeah, these are the two earrings. And with this is this piece of necklace which you might have already seen in my Hill Road haul. If you haven't seen it, I'm gonna link it up right here so you can go and check that out as well. So this is such a mirrored necklace and silver one. This is such a versatile piece, guys. I tell you, you can just pair it up with anything possible. Like I did in my video, I paired it up with kurti, I even paired it up with a plain t-shirt, and even with some top. You can pair it up with anything possible and it'll just light up the entire outfit. It'll just make you look more stylish and classy at the same time. So this is like a must-have piece in your wardrobe, and this came for 100 rupees from Hill Road. You can definitely go and watch that video and check that out, but this is my favorite. And as we have talked about jewelry, I have something which is a cute little jewelry box. So I got this from Crawford Market. If you haven't seen that video, I'm gonna link it up right here so you can go and watch that as well to know more details about the box. But this is such a beautiful piece. I mean, if you don't want to keep jewelry, if you don't want to keep anything, just keep it on the table and it'll look like a beautiful home decor stuff as well. So it's really beautiful. I really love the pattern which is going around it, and it's really, really beautiful. And I use it for keeping jewelry, but as I said, it can be used in any other way possible as well, and I really, really love it. Now the next thing is a beautiful nail paint from Nykaa. So this is basically my favorite nail paint which I'm currently obsessing on. So I'm currently wearing this nail paint as well. It is such a light matte nail paint which I was really, really in search of, and I found it on Nykaa. This one is their Corny Cream Puff shade 154. So this is how it looks. It's such a beautiful shade, guys, and I really, really love it, and I have worn it so many times that it's just gonna get over as well. So I'll have to reorder it, but this is one of my favorite things. My next favorite is something which I was really, really excited when I saw. It is basically a black mask. So this is something which my friend got it from Dubai. It is the Laser White Black Mask, which is basically a peel-off mask. So it is basically, it has whitening agents, so it just leaves your skin a little, you know, it'll remove all the tan, all the dirt, and you'll feel so fresh, smooth, and your skin starts shining as well. So it is such a thumbs up from my end. I guess it's available on Amazon as well. I'll just try to link it up right down in the description box as well. But yeah, it is one of my favorite things and I guess I'm gonna use it a lot. So now the next thing which I have is something which you will know why it is here if you know me. Okay, so if you know me or if you have been watching my videos since a really long time, you will know that I love reading novels. Now novels matlab wo moti moti kitabe nahi, guys. I am such a lovable person at heart. I love reading love stories or friendship stories, and I really love reading Indian authors more. You know, I read those stories also which are based on life. Like I have been reading The Power of Your Subconscious Mind, so I like reading those books as well. But if given a choice, I would definitely pick up a love story over those kind of books. And I really love reading Indian authors more. That is my perspective, that I feel they're more relatable. But that's just okay, that's my perspective. So I have three novels here which I'm going to talk about. So these two novels are basically from one of my favorite writer, Durjoy Dutta. Now, firstly, I love his writing. The way he writes, he'll just put you in the spot, guys. So if you're reading or if you've already read his books, you will know what I'm saying. Because, you know, you will just feel everything is just happening around you and you will feel what the character is feeling. So I really love his writing, and this was the first part. This is like, these two are part one and part two books. So this one came up first, and I'll just show you what happened. So I completed this book and I closed this book, and I had another novel ready on my table that after I complete this, I'll just, you know, like in a couple of days, I'll start reading that novel, because I had just given my NET exam, so I was little chilling and I was doing YouTubing. I was not studying anything further or I was not doing a hectic job, so I had that time to read novels. So I had ordered a couple of them in bulk, and I thought after reading this, I'll read another novel. But the moment I read the last page, I just closed this book and I took that book and I started reading. Just a minute later. This was because I wanted to forget what I have read. Actually, it had such a impact on my brain, guys. But I kind of survived this one. And then he wrote this. I didn't know initially that these are like part one and part two. So I started reading this one. And soon I realized, okay, this is like a continuation of that story. So I read. And at the end, again, I was left in a shock. So I really request you all to request him to write something nice for this particular character. And I want him to release a part 3 of these series. And name it like The Boy Who Is Now Happy or something like that. And give it a very nice happy ending. But I really, really love these books. And the next book is this one, which is by my yet another favorite author, Ravinder Singh. So he is an amazing writer. Again, guys, he writes such beautiful love stories. You must definitely try if you're in search of reading love stories, nice, good love stories. You can definitely try him. He has amazing collection and I've read all his books again. And this one is a really beautiful, mature love story. So I feel you get to learn from everything you do and everything we read. So even from love stories, you can learn something. So I learn a lot from these things as well. That's my perspective, and that's, you know, that varies from person to person. But I really love reading such books, and yeah, these are my favorites. So that's it for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you really loved what all were my favorite. What has been your favorite since a long time, or something which you have been using? Do comment below and let me know. And also put down some video requests which you want to see, and I will definitely try to do it as soon as possible. And yeah, I'll see you next time. Bye, guys.